So, my lucky number is 3 today. The first case I worked after joining the FBI had 3 victims. An unpredictable life is a wonderful thing. Cases may come flooding in like passengers at rush hour.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, finally you have arrived. You are welcome to come inside.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, Mr. Stewart has been waiting for you. To the meeting room you shall go to.
The meeting room is through here. Please be kind. Be sincere. Yes?
Mr. Francis York Morgan, please have some tea while it is hot. Too much coffee for your body will make it rot.
You seem well prepared. Almost as though you knew I would be coming today.
Mr. Stewart is particular about the best timing for all things. Now please, drink some tea and enjoy the good health it brings.
I'm sorry, Harry, but I just don't like tea.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, some tea with sugar is what's best admired.
By your body that looks so tired, so says Mr. Stewart.
Harry, where did you get these seeds?
Mr. Francis York Morgan, those seeds were found in our town in a certain specific place.
More seeds are there, you will see, when you find that certain space. Come back to me and we shall talk, after you find that certain place. So says Mr. Stewart.
Harry, so you like to play games?
Mr. Francis York Morgan, a hint for you to find this location.
It is most crowded and most quiet, and gives a cold sensation. So says Mr. Stewart.
All right. So you're not going to talk unless I find this certain place. I'll play along. Zack, let the treasure hunt begin. A crowded place, and yet it is very quiet there. Have you figured it out, Zack? It must be the graveyard. There's lots of people there, but none of them can speak. You see? So let's get going to the graveyard. Just as Harry said, it's crowded and quiet. Hey, Brian.
Agent! Mr. Agent, how are you?
Not bad. I'm, just playing a little game with Harry.
Game? A game? Oh, is that fun?
We've only just started, Brian. The fun is about to begin. I'd like to ask you something, actually. Is there a tree in the graveyard that drops red seeds?
Seeds? Red seeds? That tree does. And that one. And that one, too. All red seeds.
Brian? That's one sick joke, isn't it?
I want to die.
Accomplished. Let's get back to Harry's. The reward better be good. But you know, about these seeds. They were right here under my nose. It's as if I was carefully carrying a bottle of water while walking in a pool. We're learning the countryside version of common sense the hard way, Zach.
Thank you.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, finally you have arrived. You are welcome to come inside.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, please proceed to Mr. Stewart's room. There he awaits you, I shall assume.
Mm-hmm.
Harry, turns out what you said was true, and I'd like to hear more.
York, as you know, there's a powerful mystery surrounding these seeds. You've seen them at those other murders that took place elsewhere. And you've seen them deeply involved with the murders in this town as well.
That's right. But how do you know all this?
York, you must be younger than you look. Youngsters tend to hurry so much that they let things slip right past them.
What you need to do is slow this down. That way you'll see what's really important. Let me tell you a story. 50 years ago, when the war was over, just about when the communist Red started to become a rising threat, our town constructed a huge clock tower. Then, soon afterwards, a serial
The legend of the Raincoat Killer? Stop playing games with me, Harry. That's nothing more than folklore. The FBI has no such record of a multiple homicide case in this town.
York, Anna, Becky, and now Diane. Their deaths are real, not folklore, not legend.
Also real, but under a strict gag order, the mass murder case was never made public. In fact, one could say that it was completely erased from history. Tell me, who do you think would be able to do something like that?
The military. But if there are no records about it, then how do you know it really happened?
Good question, York. Why would I know this? The answer is very simple. I was there.
I saw it with my own eyes. The brutal killer himself. But we can talk about the details of that. Raincoat Killer. 10 and 20 years ago, I noticed that these red seeds were special, and someone else did too. The human imagination can lead to tragedy sometimes. Someone linked the red seeds to the serial killer legend and said, if you eat the red seeds and then kill someone, you will become immortal. This new fabricated legend was passed on from one to the next, evolving and changing every time like a rumor. Some may have actually taken the seeds to try them out, to prove the legend that is. York, the red seeds you have found from those other murders, they all came from this town, together with that one evil ruler. People on the other side of the planet may have heard of it by now, and new seeds might be growing in different parts of the world.
So you're saying that the series of cases I've been following are all linked to this town? That's interesting, Harry. But there's no evidence to support that story. None of the criminals we caught for the other murders ever mentioned anything like that.
It's your job. Your role and duty to look into that, York. Now, the game must go. You know, I said that the incident 50 years ago was totally erased. Well, not quite. Records still exist in the sheriff's office. The old sheriff back then hated the military and did his own investigation. I need you to bring those documents here, to me. Once you've done that, I'll tell you everything I know.
Okay, it's worth a look. And we may as well let the old man have his fun. Documents from a case that happened 50 years ago. Let's play along with the old man for a little longer, shall we?
Zack, that means we need to head for the sheriff's department.
Thank you.
here that the FBI doesn't even have? What do you think, Zach?
York! I told you! That's nothing more than local folklore!
Harry said that he was there.
The Raincoat Killer is a phantom, made up to scare children long ago. I can't believe you fell for that from Harry, of all people.
I agree with George. Harry likes to play with people, play with their minds, too.
George, Emily, of course I don't believe him word for word, but you won't mind if I at least try to confirm that he's wrong, will you?
Well then, can you look for the files by yourself? I'm still looking for Thomas.
Very well.
Emily, open the filing room for him.
They're here too, Zach. This might mean we're getting warmer to what we need. Too much noise. We're still missing a vital piece of the puzzle. Thank you.
Gosh.
Nice shot.
Nice shot.
Zach, looks like we need to continue our search for the documents.
George, I'll get right to the point. It looks like someone else has just removed the documents I'm looking for.
Huh? Removed?
The cabinet looks like it had been forced open.
That's impossible. No one could break into there.
No, Emily. There is one person that can access that room at any time.
You don't mean Thomas?
It's too early to speculate. And profiling is my job, remember? More importantly, Emily, could you get me a coffee? A fresh one, if possible.
Coffee? At a time like this? Why now?
Emily, please. This is very important. Some coffee. And bring some milk on the side. Zach, you know something, don't you? I'm getting us some coffee. So tell me what you know.
Ah, Zach, this is amazing. Even the taste of her coffee is thrilling, to say the least.
What?
No, nothing. This isn't the cup that Thomas always uses for me, is it?
I'm sorry about that too, then. I just used a cup that was nearby. You have a problem with that?
Problem? Not at all, my dear Emily. The coffee is perfect. Well, okay, taste aside, this cup certainly is perfect. George, Emily, we're going to Velvet Falls. There's something waiting for us there. I can feel it.
York, are you joking? You're trusting your cup?
No, Emily. Going to a waterfall just might be a good idea. In feng shui, a waterfall is known to be a source of power. Even if we find nothing there, I'm sure it will give us some power.
Thanks for the vote of confidence, George. And don't forget to bring a fishing rod.
All right. I'll go get it.
Fishing? Are you too serious?
George, do you have a net?